What happens when you work with a prima donna who is only worried about me, me, me?
Yeah.
Well, it's, hey, not me. It is really hard to get any work done, that's for sure, when someone like that's around. So Linda Swindling, author of Stop Complainers and Energy Drainers, joins us today to share her take on the situation. Okay, the prima donna, I think prima donna is someone who just doesn't want to get in, doesn't want to get their hands dirty, sort of puts it all on everybody else.
They can't. Or they can take, you know, attention away from you. Basically, if you thought of a road sign, it would be that curvy road,
uh-huh.
And you got to pay attention. You're going to roll on off. They're the drama queens, the drama kings of the workplace, the gossips. You know those people. And
yes.
And they're always, oh, well, no one told me. Well, yeah, you didn't show up at the meeting that everybody else went
right.
to.
Okay, right. Okay, so you have, and this is what I love in your book, too. You have some of the things that a prima donna might say. So if you have this person at work, says, hello, is anyone even listening? As always, I have to do everything. That isn't my job. I'm not doing it.
I love that one. That isn't my job.
Yeah.
I'm not doing it. Yeah. Or, no one told me.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. You weren't at the meeting.
You weren't
where we
there.
Told people.
You
yeah.
weren't there.
Yeah.
So your job is to show people how to, number one, identify
right.
this sort of coworker. And number two, learn how to work alongside this person without wanting to throttle them.
And unfortunately, not all types are the same. So you got to be able to spot your complainer's type before you try to, you know, have any kind of conversation with them.
Right, because there are
works.
Different types of complainers.
Five different types.
So mm-hmm. we're just talking about prima donna right now.
Right.
And so what are some of the other things that we can look for? And
sure.
then how do you deal with them? How do you get something done with them?
So they will be the person that doesn't take responsibility, that points the finger at other people, that, you know, stirs up the drama, the pot stirrers.
Yeah.
So if you'll go to stopcomplainers.com and take that spot your complainers type quiz, it'll show you all the different things you can look for. And if prima donnas come up, you know that they want attention. Even negative
right.
attention is better than no attention. So one of the things is you've got to recognize them. Hey, I saw you speak up in the meeting and that wasn't very positive. And then what you want to do is you want to try to redirect them to get positive attention. But the last thing is, let's say you're all working on a team and somebody says, well, we didn't do it as a team. No. Prima donna, you didn't do it as a team. Have you, you know? So
mm-hmm.
what you do with that is you assign everybody an individual role.
Right.
Then you publicize it. So Sue, you're in charge of this. You know, Darlene, you're in charge of this. Joe, you're in charge of this.
Right.
Prima donna, you're in charge of this. And then you broadcast it. Go ahead and email everybody.
Mm-hmm.
So when the prima donna lets down on the job, then everybody knows that was the prima donna's fault.
Doesn't the prima donna then say, though, well, I tried to get that done, but so-and-so didn't do their part, so I couldn't do mine. So how do you just, I mean, is it sometimes easier just to go to your boss and go, I can't work with this person. I can't do this project with this person.
Okay, so bosses want to know, so what are you proposing? And many times, a lot of people are saying, just deal with them. Just
mm-hmm.
deal with them. So one of the things you can say is, okay, if you are the boss, you can say, we're going to set that aside, and we're going to talk right now about your behavior. We'll talk in a moment about somebody who didn't do what they're supposed to do.
Right.
But also, just remember, if you can help, keep constantly thinking, what's in it for the prima donna? What's in it for that person? What are they looking for? Attention.
Right.
So you can say, wow, we really did something great together with the prima donna. All of a sudden, they start seeing that you'll brag about them when they help you out. And that's
sounds
what
like a lot
for.
Of work.
It is. It is. But imagine, I mean, so many people are dealing with these folks. Like
mm-hmm.
78% of the folks reported, and this is over 1,000 people took the survey. They said, we're spending 3 to 6 hours a week dealing with some sort of energy drainers. If you're spending that much time anyway, invest some time up front, correct the problem with those prima donnas larger than life, and then start getting work done.
Especially when you figure that, you know, if you're working a full-time job, you're spending more time, more awake time with those people at work than you
family.
Are with your family.
Right.
So these are tips that you need to learn, like, you know, ways to deal with these personalities.
Absolutely. And what's so funny is how many people tell me, oh my gosh, I'm going to work with the people at work soon. I'm working with the family today, you know,
right.
extended family or whoever.
Because you can use it outside of work as well.
Everywhere you go.
Volunteer, with friends,
volunteers. And you got to keep remembering, oh yeah, we all kind of vent a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But is that the only strategy that prima donna is using is pay attention to me, watch me, here I am, even if it's embarrassing.
Right,
yeah. Right. So you teach us ways to redirect and keep everything on course.
On track and negotiate. Because I don't want to deal with them. I don't want to manage them dealing with difficult people. No, I want them to stop. Stop coming to me.
Yeah.
You know? Get work done or go bother someone else.
Because this is what you did for a career before you kind of honed in on this specialty.
Right.
You did a lot of mediations for employment.
And I did employment law. I practiced mm-hmm. employment law for 10 years and I kept saying, why are you here? Well, it was because they didn't have good conversation
yeah.
skills.
You kept hearing the same thing over and over and over again.
Right, and a lot of it was, I'm just not getting my need met. And for prima donnas, it's, I don't feel like people are recognizing me.
Right.
So you want to, if you're in a place that you can help develop them, you want to help them recognize other people. And
okay.
that is the same.
Great tips. And you're going to come back and talk about
controllers and toxics,
which are a whole other group of people.
Right,
they
right.
need their whole other segment. Okay, thank you so much
Thanks.
For being here, Linda. You can find Linda's book at Barnes & Noble, Amazon, and pretty much most places that you buy your books today. You can also join us on the broadcast tomorrow to see Linda share another topic with us about those toxic people. You know who they are. Don't you want to know how to deal with them? Okay, when we come back, more broadcasts. Stay with us.